Now we use the pumping hammer for context-free languages to prove that this language is not context-free. And if you have absolutely no idea what I'm doing here, you may want to reach the intuition video first. And I told you that if a language is context-free, then it's pumpable, and if it's not pumpable, then it's not context-free. So we can't use the pumping lemma to prove that the language is context-free, but we can prove with it that the language is not context-free. And how we do it? We do it by, we use a proof by contradiction. That means we just assume that the language is context-free. So we assume that L is context-free. And if L is context-free, then the pumping lemma must hold for L. That means one point first. I won't write down the whole pumping lemma and the whole proof because you would have to watch me writing for hours. So I will just write it in short form, and you may want to listen what I say. So, if L is context-free, then the pumping lemma must hold, and the pumping lemma says that then there is an N that is greater or equal 0. And please note that this is a big N and that is a small N, and both of them have nothing to do with each other. That is just a variable to describe the language, to say that each occurrences of the letters is the same. And here the N is a constant in the pumping lemma. But anyway, then we have a word that is part of the language. And the word must be greater or equal than N. And for any word from the language that has the property, the pumping lemma must hold. And, well, the question is, how do we get a Z that is greater or equal than N? And one possibility would be to do something like that, to define that Z is A to the power of big N, B to the power of N, C to the power of N. Note that I inserted those variables, or those constant, as a variable for the occurrences. And now I'm sure that my Z is longer than N, because that has now a length of 3N. And for different languages, there may be other possibilities to create a word that is longer than N, but here one possibility is to do it that way. And then for this word, there must be a separation, where Z is U, V, W, X, Y, where V and X are greater or equal than 1. And VWX is smaller or equal than N. And then for all I that are greater or equal than 0, you can pump the separation to get a U, V to the power of I, W, X to the power of I, Y that's still part of the language. And you just need to find one separation in the word. So we must take into account all possibilities to show that there is no separation that for that criteria holds. So we have to prove different, we have to check different cases. And the first case, as you may we'll see in a moment, is that Y and X are only or contain only A's or only B's or only C's, and that's because, let me make it in color, that's because Y and X must be part of Y, W, U, X, and that must be shorter and equal than N. And we know that A, B and C each have the number of n. So that means one case would be, or at least three cases would be, that those window of YWX is either here, or just in the A part, or just in the B part, or just in the C part. And as you can see, and as if you would want to write down when you do the proof, is if you pump up Y and X, as the pumping lemma says, and Y and X are only A or only B or only C, then you would have a greater amount of A's or B's or C's, it doesn't matter which window you take, and then you would have a greater amount of A's or one of the other than the other two, and then the word wouldn't be in the language anymore, because the language says that the number of A's, B's and C's must be the same. So if Y and X only contains an A, and if I pump Y and X and I add a lot more A's, and then we have more A's and B's and C's, and the word is not in the language anymore, and the same is if I take the B window or the C window. And the second case we can have is that Y and X contain A's and B's, or B's and C's. And that's the other case, because those window is less or equal than n, and so it could be that the window is maybe halfway A's and halfway B's, or it contains half of the B's and half of the C's, or anything in between. So the second possibility would be that Y and X are in the part where they are A's and B's or B's and C's, and I can't take any longer window that includes all three kind of letters, because those VWX window is smaller or equal than N. And as you can see, if Y and X maybe contain A's and B's, then, well, again, you can have the cases where Y and X only include A's, or where Y and X include, maybe Y includes A's and X includes B's. And if you would pump them, then you would have the same amount of A's and B's, maybe. But A's and B's would be more than you have C's. And the same as if you take those BC windows, then you would pump B's and C's, and you would have more B's and C's than A's, and the word wouldn't be in the language anymore. And, well, in this case, you can't have a window that contains all three letters. I could have created the word and say the A's, B's and C's are one third of N, and so I could have created a window that includes the whole word, but then in that case I could only pump two of them, so either A's and B's, or either A's and C's, and so on. So it's just in no case it's possible to find a separation and pump the word so that the pumped word will stay in the language. And well, I guess that's everything I can say about that.